moving out against Tommy Bray. Tommy Bray, about 210-212 pounds, 6'1". He has been in baseball and football all of his amateur career and wrestling. In fact, he was an all-state running back. But he's moving out against Killer Brooks, and I'll tell you something about this man, Brooks. As I've said before about him, he's an exceptionally efficient wrestler. And I must say that I am more than idly curious about Zabisco's comments about some sort of possible or pending business relationship between Brooks and Zabisco himself. Bright driven up against the turnbuckle, and it's Brooks with a snap mare. Takes Bright back to the canvas. Drives the knee across the lumbar region of the back. That does the back of the rib cage a lot of damage as well. Come on, how about it? Got him in a Russian sickle now, and this is the thing about Brooks, of course, he's wrestled all over the world. And he is as dangerous a competitor as I've ever seen in the ring. And the funny thing is that the more he gets hurt, the more vicious he becomes as a competitor. And Bright in a lot of trouble. The referee, Nick Patrick, asking him if he wants to concede, and he shook his head no. Nick Patrick is a very, very conscientious official. Bright in a lot of trouble now as Brooks has completely dominated the situation. He's, has him under total control. Brooks catching him again and again in the back, jarring that spinal column.
Off the hair, one, two, three.
Caught him that time, and oddly enough, that was with the inside of the fist. Smashes him back into that far turnbuckle, and Bright in a lot of trouble. Bright's eyes having trouble focusing now as Brooks can, ooh, man, caught him with a high knee. Catches him again, and I don't know how much more Bright can take before his body is going to collapse on him. A backbreaker. Brooks crashes down right across the throat. It's all over. Reverse inverted press, hooks the leg, and he scores the pinfall on the victory.